the Tour of California coming up this weekend, and the tour has added something this year, which I think is pretty cool. It's added an additional women's event. So joining us today to talk about the women's time trial and a circuit race is Heather LaPagna and Judy Wexler, both of whom will be racing coming up this weekend. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you for having us.
And so you guys race with which team?
Folsom Bike, presented by Cervelo. Mm-hmm.
Excellent. So you're local riders and have an invitation to take part in this. So having the second event for the women, what does it mean to you?
It's great because the Amgen Tour has been such a staple on the men's calendar, and they've had a time trial for women the past couple of years, but adding the circuit in Sacramento as the men go off, I think really highlights our sport and shows people who are already coming to watch the men what the women have been doing all along.
And I would argue the women's race is as good and as fast and as crazy as the men's.
Definitely.
Racing is racing. I mean, especially in the last, I would say, few years, the women have taken it to the next level and really tried to be active. And it's, I mean, we put on a good show, I think, and it's exciting to watch, you know?
You put on a great show, mm-hmm. But what a lot of people don't know about female racers at this level is that most of you have other lives because it's not a main source of income. So you tell me a little bit about the other things you do, because riding is secondary to what
right.
you do.
So I'm a graduate student at UC Davis. I study evolutionary biology, and for me it's just a matter of balancing what I'm doing in the lab with getting in my training, racing on the weekends. So yeah, it can be a handful.
Definitely, yeah. I mean, working and being a mother and balancing a training schedule and the races on the weekend. I mean, if you're organized, I mean, you do what you have to do to get your training in, and it pays off. It's worth it. Yeah.
How old are your kids?
My daughter's 12.
Almost 13. Are you the coolest mom at school, or what?
She thinks I'm pretty cool. So I'll go with that. I'll let her think
you're
that.
You're certainly the fastest mom at school. I'm sure. So when can we see you race?
We'll be out there on Sunday, shortly after the men depart, I think.
Yep, we'll be out there. Our race starts at noon on Sunday, right around the Capitol. So it's a fun race to watch. It'll be really fast, a lot of action, so you'll see us come around a lot. And you can also walk around and see different parts of the course as well. So it should be fun.
Excellent.
And there's a lot of people. The energy is really electric, and it's fun. Definitely
recommend
it.
And the women's race is just one of the things that will be going on that morning. So if you go out to the festival, you'll still be able to see lots of different things. They keep you busy while you're waiting for the racers to get
Definitely.
Back. The one thing you hope that little girls, especially who are out at that race this weekend, get from seeing what you do?
That girls can go just as fast as boys, and it's just as fun.
Right, and hopefully inspire them to want to do something, even if it's not bike racing, you know, that it's competitive, but it's a healthy competitive, that we're having fun, we're pushing ourselves, you know, and that's kind of what it's all about.
Best thing a guy has said when you lapped him. Don't tell me it hasn't happened.
I won't repeat it on television.
Sometimes, yeah, you don't want to say that again.
Well, best of luck this weekend.
Thank you.
Nice to have a local team getting to take part in this.
And, yes.
Cheers to Amgen for bringing a second women's event.
Definitely.
Utah also adding a women's event this year, too.
Right, I know. We're getting there.
Yes, we are.